He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, let's check out a few problems regarding the properties of gases. Number one says, equal masses of methane and oxygen are mixed in an empty container at 25 degrees Celsius. What is the fraction of the total pressure exerted by oxygen? Number two asks, a gas will approach ideal behavior at, and then there are some options here regarding temperature and pressure. And then number three says, the ratio of the rate of diffusion of helium to methane under identical conditions of pressure and temperature is, and again, there are some numerical options here. So some different things here about gases. You may want to review some of my tutorials regarding ideal gases and non-ideal gases, as well as diffusion, things of that nature. And when you're ready, give it a try. So for this first one, it specifies that we have equal masses of methane and oxygen. So in this kind of a case, it might be useful to just go ahead and assume an arbitrary mass. So let's arbitrarily choose 32 grams of each gas, and you could choose any number you like. I'll show you why 32 is very convenient, because now we can convert from grams into moles, right? Because moles are going to tell us something about the total pressure. So let's convert our gram values into moles. We have 32 grams of oxygen times 1 mole for every 32 grams, because 32 grams is the molar mass of O2. So we have 1 mole of oxygen. Then we have 32 grams of methane as well, because we have the same mass of each, and that will be times 1 mole over 16 grams, because methane has a molar mass of 16. So that means we have 2 moles of methane. Now, what we need to understand is that the partial pressure of oxygen, which is what we're looking for here, it says what is the fraction of the total pressure exerted by oxygen, that's going to be equal to the mole fraction of oxygen over the total moles, because the fraction of the molecules that are represented by oxygen will represent the fraction of the total pressure. That's how pressure works. And so we need to see that we have 1 mole of oxygen for every 3 moles of gas in total, because we have 1 mole of oxygen for every 2 moles of methane. So 1/3 of the gas particles in the sample are oxygen molecules. And that means that 1/3 of the total pressure is exerted by oxygen. Now, looking at number two, we're trying to describe ideal gas behavior. Now, what are the assumptions we're making when we're talking about an ideal gas? Well, assumption number one is that the gas particles do not interact, right? We're saying that these are just little points and that they don't interact. They just fly around and bounce around. And so in terms of temperature, this is presuming a higher temperature, because this would mean that the gas particles move very quickly as opposed to them moving very slowly, which would result in them having time to interact with one another as they pass by one another and collide. If two polar gas molecules pass by each other very slowly, they will have time to make electrostatic interactions. So ideal gas behavior precludes higher temperatures. Assumption number two is that the gas particles take up negligible volume. We ignore the volume of the gas particles themselves when talking about an ideal gas. And so this would require that we're looking at lower pressures, because the gas particles must be very sparse. It must be a lot of empty space in the vessel. If it was very high pressure, that would mean the gas had been rather compressed, and that would mean that the gas particles are very close to one another, so there wouldn't be as much empty space, and therefore the volume of the gas particles themselves would be a significant fraction of the total volume. And so we could no longer ignore the volume of the gas particles. So we need high temperatures and low pressures to be able to assume ideal gas behavior. So that's going to be option C, high temperature and low pressure. Now, number three, we're looking at the ratio of the rate of diffusion of helium to methane. So what is the equation we're going to use? Well, we know that the ratio, this ratio that we're describing, helium to methane, so let's put R helium over R methane, that is going to be equal to the square root of the molar mass of methane over the molar mass of helium. So this is an important equation to understand when we're looking at diffusion or effusion, basically any aspect of the movement of gaseous particles. Notice that we have a square root on the right over the molar masses, and we have inverted the order of the substances. So we have methane on top and helium on the bottom. So let's go ahead and plug these in. We're going to put square root of the molar mass of methane, which is 16, over the molar mass of helium, which is 4. And that is equal to 2. So helium will diffuse twice as fast as methane because it has a quarter the molar mass. So that is going to be B2.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.